Can we make a 3D Benchy out of cardboard? I have cardboard, a fast laser cutter, but where do we start? How do we turn this into this, but with a Benchy? Wait, that doesn't look simple at all. But it used to be. This was 123D Make from Autodesk, that later became Slicer for Fusion 360, and it was truly amazing. From any STL, you could make stacks and even interlocked slices. It even showed you step-by-step instructions on how to assemble, and it generated the vector plans to laser cut the pieces with all parts marked with numbers. And to hold all pieces aligned, it could even cut slots and make dowels. This tool was easy and free. What happened? Autodesk pulled the plug. Of course. So I'll try to make my cardboard bench using mostly open source tools. And here's the plan. We'll start with the STL model. I'll make it 4 times bigger than the original. And with some sort of slicer, we'll generate the drawings for laser cutting. To help assembling it straight, it is important to have dowel holes. The dowels need to be thin, so I'll use skewer sticks. We also want numbers on all parts. We will squeeze the drawings together to fit our boards. Then we will choose a nice laser software to cut everything on the laser machine and finally have some fun gluing. Before you forget, please like this video. On Prusa Slicer, I can scale my Benchy up to 400% and export the build plate. Now we have a new STL that is 4 times the original size. Check! Moving on to generating the SVGs. Have you ever heard of Kiri, Moto?
What?
Me neither, and that's crazy, because it is an impressive full slicer. It can do 3D printing, CNC milling, and laser cutting. It is open source and it runs JavaScript completely in the browser. Let's open the Benchy STL, change it to laser mode, measure the thickness of our cardboard sheets, and that's our layer height. Here's the preview of all the parts, and we can export to SVG. Kiri Moto is a great tool, but all the layers are put together on a single giant layout, way bigger than what I can fit into my laser machine. Parts are not numbered, and it doesn't help with the dowels. So let's get back to the STL, because if we punch holes on the model itself, then Kiri Moto will draw the circles on every slice, and the laser will cut the holes for us. On Prusa Slicer, you can make holes in any model. We just add negative volumes, and they become holes when you 3D print. I am not printing. I want to export holes on a new STL, and the newest version of Prusa Slicer can do it. Or so they say. Because I got an error saying exactly that it could not perform the Boolean operation. Bummer. I have no other choice but Blender! Well, Blender can do anything to a mesh, and I just need a few holes.
A few hours of tutorials later.
Big thanks to Jonathan Maker Tales. I'll put links to his Blender tutorials in the description, because they saved me. First of all, do we really need these holes? Look, at the bottom, the Benchy is a solid chunk, and every layer will generate a single piece. But when it gets higher, it will start having multiple parts on every layer, like here, 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 see? So if we don't have guides, everything will be misaligned. So I made 4 holes on the corners of the cabin, 2 holes on the sides of the hull, 1 for the keel, and 2 more for the chimney. I will export the mesh as STL, and there we have it! Dowel holes, yay! Back to Kiri Moto. I'll slice it again. Everything has dowel holes and we can export to SVG. This one was fast. This giant blueprint doesn't fit my laser, so I used Inkscape to separate the whole thing into a few layout sheets. I don't like Inkscape, but it is open source and it works. I also added layer numbers on every single piece. The colors here are important. I am choosing red for the things that I want the laser to just engrave, and I'm using black for for everything I want to actually cut through. Every material needs different laser settings. For example, to cut, we use full power. But if it moves too fast, it won't cut through. And if it's too slow, the material can catch fire. It's true. It's fine. We are burning. It's burning. Sometimes it is safer to cut in a few quick passes instead of a single slow pass. These settings we adjust on a laser software. And I have three options. Laser Gerbil is open source, but it has very limited drawing tools. Also, Laser Gerbil only runs on Windows and I have a Mac. Lightburn is my favorite. It is super complete. You can draw, it is fast, it runs on Windows, Mac, Linux. It is paid, but it's not expensive. It works with all laser machines. But we are not using Lightburn today because this laser machine, the xTool S1, it has some cool new features that I really want to play. So I need xTool Creative Space. I'll put my cardboard here, and this is the laser pointer. I don't need to adjust, it should measure the focus distance automatically. And they say that if I move the laser head with my hand, let's see, if I move the laser head with my hand, it also moves on the screen. This is so cool. There is a framing thing to mark the size of the material we are using. You move to one corner, press the button, move to another corner, press again. It got the points. So this green area is my cardboard. Let's do it. Oh, I need to close the lid. Now it is burning. You are seeing everything green because if I open the lid, the machine stops. And that's the idea. The laser is completely enclosed. Nobody needs glasses and this is much safer. The smoke. Laser cutting makes a lot of smoke and that's very annoying with open machines. But this one is closed and it came with an exhausting tube and all the smoke goes outside. xTool sent me the S1 for me to play and show it here. It's excellent. It's not cheap. Let's say it's another level. I will put affiliate links for this machine in the description. So if you want to buy one, please use my links. It is the same price and you will help my channel. These are the leftovers, and here are all the pieces you need to stack a 30 layers cardboard 3D Benchy. What do you think? I actually prefer the calibration cube because I used 3 millimeters cardboard. But if I used that for the Benchy, I would have 60 layers to glue instead of 30. I wish more people would know about laser cutters. They are not toys, they are powerful tools. And machines like the S1 bring a new level of safety. The S1 finally did it. I have a dedicated space for a laser machine on my workshop. So gluing took me 1 hour. Laser cutting was 15 minutes, it was fast. Preparing the model, the drawings, numbers, sheet layouts, it took me the whole day. If you know any new software, easy tools, please tell us in the comments because we need tools that anyone or more people could use. Here you have more laser videos. Should I make toys with lasers, art, functional objects? So tell me what you wanna see on this machine. I want to mix laser cutting and 3D printing, so subscribe and thank you so much for watching.